Hey guys, Cool Blind Boy back. I'm Rick.
Eric.
Aaron.
My Hero Academia has returned.
My hero.
It has returned. We're on episode 4 of this season. You gotta make sure you subscribe so you get the rest of the season reactions as well. So go ahead and do that right now. Hit that button. Yeah. Subscribe.
If you don't subscribe, they won't show up.
Yep.
It's magic. YouTube's weird.
Last time on!
A versus B.
Yes.
B. Who will win?
We just kind of started.
We have groupings, right? Four-person groups, I believe, on each side. However, we have the control your body dude when he talks to you.
Shinzo.
Who also has some kind of voice modulator where he can pretend to voice other people. Mm-hmm. So he's like, hey, what's up? And they're like, hey, I'm doing good.
Nate.
Damn it, no, that wasn't Rick. Ah! Yeah. You know, so.
I love it. I think it's a great addition to his already very interesting power.
Sure. So he's on Sue and whoever else, electric dude, maybe. Was that who it was? Who was on Sue's team? Sue. Some other people.
I didn't write down the teams.
I forget who was on Sue's team, but it was that group. But then later on, he's going to be on the B's team fighting against Midoriya and his grouping.
Yep.
So is that what we're going to be for this episode? Or are we going to have some other things with Hawks and whatnot kind of tied in? Or
Triple double agent. Also,
I'm a hamburger now.
We got to talk a little bit with All Might, but I didn't feel like I got too many crazy answers that I was looking forward to.
He didn't have them.
He had no answers. He didn't know shit.
He was just like, oh, interesting.
Who are those shadow people?
I've seen that.
And apparently he's the golden dude. So we learned that, I guess.
That was learned. That was answered. Let's find out what some other dudes were. Maybe. I don't know. We'll see.
One match down. Sue MVP.
I was kind of worried at one point, but they pulled it off. It is about experience, and Class A is a lot of experience.
They do.
I think it's that, and it's also a tight matchup, too, a bit, right? Yeah. Like, they were lucky that, like, if you would have replaced Sue with someone else, you might not have had a way of trying to camouflage your scent.
True.
Right?
Yeah.
And that helped them to not be able to pinpoint where Shinzo was.
Mm-hmm.
And I think that that also then, while we had Sue and what's the electric guy's name?
Kaminari.
Like, well, you had him there. He was then able to track down. So that meant you were luring the beast away. That's why he was inside that thing. He should have teared through to get to it, you know? So a little bit of it. I'm curious on how tight matchups are going to kind of play into it later on.
True.
But I think it also, like, experience is going to be a big thing. But I don't know. Like, Shinzo has no experience. But technically, neither does Class B. They just have schooling.
Yeah.
So experiences some of it, but like, how well do they know their powers? How much have they worked together? This guy hasn't worked with any of these people.
No, just, he's from general studies, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, well,
he just learned about his quirk during the match.
Yeah.
So they didn't have time to like plan and strategize, where 1B has been working together for a while.
Yeah.
So I'm sure they all know each other.
Same with 1A. 1A has been working together. Like, we'll probably get into some later 1A versus 1B matchups where 1A is going to be like, we know each other because we've already done this, this, and this.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's why All Might said, like, even though you get an extra person, he's really a liability
to
you.
But, you know, I guess, like, as the team, because he's going to be in, is he going to be in every match or just?
No, he's in that one.
He's only in this
and
one?
And then he's in another one later on on 1B's team.
Okay,
1B's. So they're going to have kind of an advantage because they all sat and watched as it happened. A little more understanding of his power.
They may understand the vocal changes. Yeah. But it's also going to be 4v5, where the other team may also understand the vocal changes and how they can use it. Dude, the thing I love about it is, like, sure, the voice thing, once you know about it, like, okay, well, if you don't respond to him, we'll be good. But that turned into not knowing what communications to trust or to not have any communication at all.
Yeah. No, I loved it.
Breaks it down even more to where, like, well, now you're hindering them by not even using your power because they're afraid of what could be the power.
Yeah.
Which is awesome.
It's fantastic. Like, and honestly, it reminds me of, like, Naruto substitution jutsu, where sometimes I just don't think of it, and it happens. I'm like, fucking, it got me, you know?
Sure.
This got me whenever he suddenly responded as the other guy mid-battle, and it just hit. You know, I'm like, oh, fuck, he did it, you know? That's what makes it so great.
Like, before, I didn't understand why he was wearing a Eraserhead scarf.
Uh-huh.
But it kind of makes sense now, because, yeah, he doesn't nullify quirks, but he does nullify communication.
Yeah.
Well, sure. And, like, his power isn't necessarily, like, you want to have something to fall back to, right?
Sure.
Like, sure, Eraserhead can nullify some quirks, but not all quirks either. He also needs to be good at combat in some way, so
that's
he kind of supplements
that
with
crazy
a scarf,
thing.
You know?
Like, he has to be just as good as everybody without a quirk a that really quirk. Gives him anything. Yeah.
Now, if he can trick someone into joining, like, being brainwashed, then he could use them against each other, which is how he got the vines to wrap around the other two. But it's just a very interesting thing where, like, it's hard to kind of pinpoint, like, how useful will this be? And can he be as good on his own? Like, I don't know. Like, so, I imagine he could, but once people know who he is, then that adds some problems. So,
they need to find a way, like, the opposing team needs to find a way to, like, communicate without voice, like hand signals, or it'd be great if you had, like, Megan from Young Justice on your team.
Yeah.
Because then you could have a telepathic link to everybody.
Having that telepathic kind of connection.
There was one of the, like, I want to call them the Pussycats, although I don't think that's what they were called.
Yeah, the cat people.
But, like, one of them had a... not telepathy, but like being able to talk with the mind.
I believe they did, yeah.
I kind of forget. There was the really strong dude.
Yeah.
And then there was it three of them?
There
was
three
it four?
Of them. I think there were three.
Well, one lost their.
Didn't one
quirk.
Die or something? Oh, is that what it was?
Yeah.
Was a quirk?
Yeah, they
one
stole the quirk for Anomu.
I thought one of them could like broadcast messages.
They did. The other one was like Terra Kinesis. Could like use like Earth to make things, like monsters and stuff.
But yeah, no, they can find a way to communicate and stuff too. But that's why, you know, when the Beast Dude started taking off and he just pointed, like, that doesn't help me at all. He's like, "What do you mean?" And then they broke down. And then he didn't even, when he was being warned to duck, he didn't trust it because he thought it was a trick.
Well, you could, like, what if they all had headsets or ear sets or something? And if they're responding to someone in the ear set, then he can't. Do it, right?
Yeah, I believe so. You say it can't go through, like, the radio or a microphone,
instead of a megaphone,
right?
Or whatever.
Because, like, even if you and I are right here where we are, if we're both wearing headsets, and I'm responding to you in the headset instead of you here sitting here, like, would that nullify the quirk?
Unless, well, I mean, if he could hear you, then I think that would work, right?
But I think it has something to do with intent.
It has to be a response to the person. It has to be a response to him.
Yeah, it's not just someone talking.
Yeah. Like, if it's Rick has this power, and I'm talking to you, and you're talking to me, neither of us will be brainwashed. We have to actually be communicating to him specifically. But then also comes into play the other team and stuff, too. Like, if you have the electricity guy, or maybe phone jack? Earphone jack? Ear jack?
Ear jack.
Having her, like, could they... nullify that, stop those from working somehow or something, and then now you don't have those to rely on either.
Sure.
So that's what I'm wondering, like, how good alone can he get? And on a one-on-one basis, I really don't feel like it's, like, his power won't be that great, right? But when he's fighting a group, that could be useful, or when he's fighting with a group, that could also be useful. It's just a matter of, like, you know, if you and I are fighting and I have that power, you're going to know not to talk to me. Mm-hmm. No matter what voice I use, it's not going to matter, you know? And I'm like, I just pick some random voice that I know you know, like, "Hey, Eric, look out behind you." And you're like, "Calvin? Ah, damn it, no!"
That's why it would be amazing if you could get a sidekick that compels you to speak.
That's true. Like, also, if he can utilize stealth. Like, if he can trigger that power before the fight even starts.
Yeah.
The thing, though, about compelling him to speak is that still work within the guidelines of what he has to have.
I believe so, because it just said that he has to focus and have intention on someone.
Yes.
They don't have to have intention back.
Well, they have to communicate back to him.
They do, but like if he asks you a question and then you are compelled to speak, I think that is good.
But I'm asking, like, if I have the power to do that, but Rick's forcing you to speak, are you still going to be brainwashed because you're not choosing to speak? You're being forced to speak, kind of, you know? I don't know if there's any kind of confliction.
Yeah, I don't know if the intention has to go both ways. I don't know.
Imagine if it's...
He has to communicate back to him. So there has to be an intent of, like, responding to whatever. But if you have no control of that, I don't know if that removes it.
Like, what's her name? Ino in Naruto?
Mm-hmm.
Like, if she leaves her body, goes into Eric's body.
Yeah.
And then talks as Eric.
Who's controlled?
Yeah.
Is Eric controlled or is she controlled? And then if she leaves the body, who's controlled? So, yeah, I don't know. It's that thing of, like, how will powers combine and what's the weakness and strengths of them? And is the rules for them, how do they work?
Like, he needs to get some bots, too, that he can just, like, put places and talk through. Although it wouldn't work. It has to be his voice.
It has to be his voice. That's the thing.
It has to be
his voice. One thing he used here was the echoes, but it was still, like,
what if he casts Magic Mouth?
It's interesting that his, like, what are you talking about? He doesn't have a magic mouth. It's not D&D. But, like, this thing with, like, the plates where it's, like, it's still his voice, like, going through plates and changing the sound of them.
Mm-hmm.
But it's not going through, like, an electronic...
It's not being digitized.
It's not, yeah, there's no digitation.
Yeah, there's no recreation. That's his actual voice. This is a recreation of his voice going through, like, a phone, let's say.
Sure.
You know?
Yeah. So that's interesting. I like that there's rules for a lot of this stuff, you know? Like, you could just be like, if you he can tell you to do anything.
I mean, the limitations voice, you know? Like, make it interesting, you know? Yeah. And My Hero's been good about that.
That's the thing you got to work around then, yeah. You know?
I mean, we get so hyped with Midoriya because his potential is not having limitations, you know? But we're going to have this whole season, or whole series, he's going to have limitations until then, you know?
Well, like the Dragon Shroud guy, right? The scales, like, that's interesting. Like, he can make scales to make armor. He can shoot his scales, but that doesn't necessarily give him super strength. He doesn't have speed. He just has, like,
A lot like Hawk's power. It's just scales instead of feathers.
Yeah, is there a limit to how many scales he can make?
Yeah, that's one of the things I don't know either. Like, can he run out of them like the feathers do? Or
I mean, Hawk can control his feathers, right?
Can he just grow them as he needs to?
Yeah.
Like, Popoff,
maybe he'll be able to control his scales later.
Like, Popoff can kind of just grow them, but he does get weaker the more of those he uses,
he starts
right?
to bleed and stuff, yeah.
So, like, what, I don't know. I'm not sure what the limitations are, but though.
Scales. I'm just trying to think of everything you could do with scales. Does he like much? Armor?
Weigh things?
Do, re, mi, fa, sa, la, ti, do.
I regret the question.
But, no, yeah, I just... At the very least, if he's fighting a group of people, it can always cause problems as to communication.
Yeah.
Which is the cool thing of, like...
Or yeah. He is fighting that one guy who had multiple personalities.
Does that work? What if you're answering yourself?
Twice.
What happens there?
I don't know. The Deadpool guy.
You gotta listen to those two lawyer guys always put videos up. Whenever they're like, ask a lawyer something. It's like, you do this, and you shut the fuck up. You ever watch those guys? It's hilarious, but it always ends with, you know, call your lawyer and shut the fuck up. They have, like, New York accents. It's really funny. But that's what you gotta do. You just gotta shut the fuck up and fight, you know? Don't say anything. And fight. Fight.
Didn't get to be used, but I like to think he's... little tracker that also directs the lightning.
It, like, attracts it?
Yeah. I thought that was really cool.
Yeah.
Neat little power.
I like that as well. I like that we also had a little flashback back to season one.
Yeah, during the fight at the JSA?
Yeah, Justice Society of America.
Yeah, I think so. At first I saw the boat and I thought it was, like, her little side mission.
Yeah.
It wasn't that.
No, those three were off on their own whenever they got, like, transported throughout.
Isn't that when they did, like, a whirlpool and shit?
Yeah. Yeah, popped off. Oh, yeah. That was one of the first times we really got to see Midoriya, like, punch, you know, the way he punches. Second time, but one of the first. I just remember seeing goddamn hype seeing that kid punch, you know?
Didn't he just punch the air?
And one of the last.
And it was amazing. He created, like a tornado or something, didn't he?
No, I mean, there was a whirlpool that happened. Yeah. And then he, like, threw pop-off stuff and stuck people into the whirlpool or something.
They fought, like, 100 guys. I mean, granted, they sucked, but 100, you know?
Yeah, some of those guys are just dumb people that just...
Like, I know, but still, that's a lot of people.
I don't even know if they know how to fight.
Like, if you had the world's best swordsman against 100 guys with swords, like, they're gonna get them, you know?
They didn't. We saw that, Eric.
Yeah, but you need three guys against 100 guys.
I did watch a... It was like the three best fencing people in this one country versus like 100 people.
Yeah.
And they had to fight. It was pretty fun.
Interesting.
Who won?
The multitude won, but it got fairly close.
You gotta get tired eventually, right?
Like, yeah.
If you had to fight 100 guys just in a row, as soon as you beat one, the next one's up, like, I feel like I would just be tired by the end of it. I'm bound to lose, you know? Like, it's just an endurance thing because you're going against a fresh person, and I just had to beat one guy, you know?
Mm-hmm. Yep.
Huh. So, but with them, what they did is they took them all out at once. That's what you gotta do. If they had some kind of whirlpool fencing weapon thing, they could win.
Now, Shinso said that he doesn't think he could do it to more than one person, right?
It's something he's never tried, but he thinks it's, yeah, he thinks like, that it would
I
be
wonder what his limit could be
on trying to communicate to different people and telling what to do.
Because he got through the sports festival by controlling people that were holding him up, right? Was he just doing that to one person?
I don't think he was controlling all of them, right?
I can't remember, but I thought that was part of it. Wasn't he controlling people?
Yeah.
But it wasn't all four of them then. It was just one?
Well, they didn't know his power at the point then.
True.
And I thought that he was doing it like, because they had to get like the ribbons or whatever. Mm-hmm. I thought like, they're just like, wait, what happened? He got my ribbon. And yeah. I thought he was just telling the people that had the ribbon, give me a ribbon. He gave me a ribbon.
It could be that. I guess I assumed back then that he was controlling his like group.
He wouldn't need to necessarily, right?
Because they could all work as one.
They're all, but they all, they are.
That's yeah, but sometimes you're like, go left. No, I'm going right.
We're not Anakin.
No, I'm taking him now. You know? It happens. That's how he does it.
I know.
He does this.
I know. I don't know. I like it and I hate it too.
I love it. If you tell Christopher Lee, hey, do something with your fingers and make it look like you're shocking someone, you do whatever the fuck he wants. Joris Kabah from the books did this.
I just got to the point whenever like the Nicesters come in.
Yeah.
Like, man, I can just picture Christopher Lee just sleeping in pajamas on top of everything. Just,
hell yeah.
Just like
I
this.
I know.
Just laying there to sleep.
No blanket.
No blanket, no nothing. Just.
What sorcery is this?
Yeah.
Sorry. We got distracted. I love the moment where he's like, Eraserhead taught me well. That was great.
But all he did was grab a pipe.
And it worked.
It didn't work.
Let me get a pipe. Let me hit your head. See if it works.
He's not a beast.
I'm not a beast monster.
Exactly.
What?
Guys, thank you very much for watching this episode of My Hero Academia. Make sure you subscribe. That way, every time a new reaction comes up, not just of My Hero, but all the other stuff we do, which is vast and mighty.
Which is?
You get notified. Hit the little bell, too. I hear that helps, though. I've never really done it.
You never heard a bell before?
I'm going to do the bell right now, though.